Hello, my name is Frances Reed and I'm Programme Director for the World Ovarian Cancer Coalition. For this champion chat, I'm delighted to talk to colleagues in Italy from the group ACTO, to their Vice President, Emanuela Bellet. She's going to tell us about their programme, Movimento e Salute, Exercise for Health. Emanuela, can you explain the basic idea behind the programme?
Yes. The basic idea is that when we are treated with chemotherapy and after that, the movement could help us from a lot of point of view. Physical, because exercise, even if you are tired due to therapy that are hard to support, could allow us to have more energy, because the movement make energy, and also for a psychological and resilient point of view, because generally when we make movement, we are at in open air, in a park with green or near the seaside for the people, or near the mountains. It depends where you live. It's in open air, and so we can have some energy also for the psychological point of view.
So if I was a woman with ovarian cancer and I was wanting to join the program and I did the questionnaire about, you know, my health at the moment and my quality of life, what would then happen on the programme? What does it actually involve? What do women have to do and what do the clinicians do? Or
so the clinician first present the project that I have made with the support of an application on the smartphone, an application that make a personal movement. So all the women have a trainer, all this group of women have the same trainer, and this trainer are have a degree in exercise science, and they make, and is a real trainer, is not an avatar or a voice, but is a real trainer with a name, is a person, and make a tailored movement for every woman. Depend on what you want to make and your approach to the movement, because there are some people that make movement before become the disease of ovarian cancer. Someone that don't make no movement during their life. So they is a tailored, personalized movement that is different from one to one. If you reach some goals, some better goals, they make you a different plan of movement. So is going on this movement.
So it progresses or with you as you go
yes.
along?
Yes.
So other women, are they walking? Are they running? Are they cycling? What type of movements are involved?
This type of project is, the application is for walking and run. But they suggest the scientific committee for generally for women with ovarian cancer is to make a slowly walking.
So it's not too daunting to start on such a program like this. It is a big step for some women, but it actually is just about working with where they are at that point in time.
Yes, because some women, two or three women that participate to this project, never walk in their life, because they are afraid to walk due to the disease. And they discover a new world walking with a trainer that is so pretty, is a young woman, so pretty, that is step by step suggest, even if you are tired, no, go It's better if you go, and then we create a community dedicated to this project with WhatsApp, only dedicated to the project. So when we go walk, we make a photo. when we reach the goal, and so it's a good thing also to divide it with other people your goals. You are a part of a community. Also, it's a little community, but it's very important because we are every with ovarian cancer, with different moments of the life, someone with chemotherapy, someone not. But it's a good, I think it's a good thing to be related in a community.
To have that support from others who are going through a similar situation. Yes. So the benefits, I can obviously see that the women enjoy the community aspect and will get strength from that. How are they reporting finding the exercise program?
Every comments are positive. Every woman are very happy of this project, and they hope to go on with this project because with the sponsorship, we offer this project with no cost to all the women.
And you have a group in Milan. You're about to start a group in Florence.
Yes.
And there are plans to spread even further.
Yes, yes. We hope. Now we are training to have some sponsorship because there are a lot of costs related to the cost of a trainer and to the app. Are this the principal cost? So we try to go to have some sponsorship to go on with other group, probably in Bari, in Sicily. This type of app is the first type in Europe because it's not with voice or an avatar, but is with real person. That is the difference. Real person and tailored movement. I become sick in 2012, and I was a high grade of ovarian cancer, and I did not expect to make such a lot of things in my life in these years. And the movement is one of the better things I make. Is one of my best friend that is a runner that approached me to this possibility of a movement. And so I was so grateful, and I want to expand this possibility to all the women with ovarian cancer. And for this, I was very grateful to the president of ACTO, Nicoletta Cerana, that helped me to explain this project to clinician, to the sponsor that help us to go on.
So I think the strength of it is it's also tied into the clinical community, to the doctors, and hopefully there'll be a research paper based on it at the end of this as well.
Yes, I think because we have a lot of benefits at the end of a first group that make movement for 8 months. But I think when we have some more women that makes that, it's possible for the clinician to write a paper.
Congratulations. I think it's a wonderful program.
Thank you.
And I wish you all the best in spreading it out far and wide.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Emanuela.
Thank you.